Okay, class. So today we are going to continue with guys' web test. Okay, dan kita masih lagi berada dalam goodness of fit. Okay, so goodness of fit. Okay, so today dalam goodness of fit kita dah cakap what is the purpose of guys' web test. Kita ada data, and then the data we want to see whether a certain distribution can fit with the data or not. Okay, so that's what we call as goodness of fit. So hari ni kita nak tengok goodness of fit in terms of discrete distribution. Okay, so yang pertama kita nak tengok dalam discrete distribution. Apa discrete distribution? Example of discrete distribution. Kita ada normal distribution. Binomial distribution. Okay, we also have Poisson. And if you are given with discrete probability distribution. Okay, so kita ada tiga distribution that we are going to see today. So before we proceed, let's recall dulu. Awak ada tengok dalam last week, recall dulu. Okay, so in order for you to carry out the chi-square test, kita recall steps dia. Okay, so if katakanlah soalan tu, you can define normally binomial, Poisson, discrete, you can define your random variable x. So you define your x. Okay, you define your x because binomial, Poisson, you can define. Okay, so step one awak adalah hypothesis. Okay, so hypothesis awak, you write your h naught and then you write your h prime. Okay, and then step two awak adalah expected frequency. So apa yang awak tulis? Awak akan tulis if H naught is true, the expected frequencies. So apa yang awak buat? Okay. So awak biasanya salin table. So this one adalah awak punya x. Okay, so this one awak salin kan, awak ada O. Okay, so untuk bila kita ada distribution, saya nak awak extra akan satu P. Okay, P awak kena ada your row for probability, and then awak ada E equals to NP. Okay, so here you must show one looking. Okay, untuk expected frequency awak show one frequency. So the first awak buat table awak, in order for you to get the P, you must calculate the probability, right? So saya nak awak show dekat P kat bawah dia tu, show calculation of probability. Okay, show one only, once. Okay, yang lain tu awak just fill up the table only. So kita nak kira probability, kita recall balik. Okay, macam mana kita nak kira binomial? Px equals to R equals to N Cr Pr Qa minus R. Ini adalah untuk binomial. Okay, untuk Poisson, macam mana formula untuk Poisson? X equals to R E minus lambda, lambda to the power of R over R factor Ini adalah komponen bentuk kuasa. Okay. And then here, okay, how to make nota kat sini. Delta expected frequency combined if E less than 5. Okay, kita tak nak E yang small. Kita nak E yang big, big E only. Kita tak nak small E. Okay, so kita akan combine kalau E kita small. Later I will show you what do I mean by combine if E is small. Okay, so step 1, step 2 we are done. Step 3, degree of freedom. Okay, so formula kita apa? V equals to K minus 1. Okay, remember K is after combining column. Okay, after awak combine, itulah nilai K awak. Okay, you must combine first. Okay, number 4. Okay, number 4 adalah significant level. Okay, so apa yang kita tulis dalam significant level? So kita akan tulis the expected at, for example, 5% significant level. So our alpha is 0.05 chi squared alpha v. V saya, I don't know, for example v. And then you get your value from your table. And then remember to sketch. Okay, this is your rejection area. What this one is your chi squared alpha v. Okay, so that is step number 4. Step number 5. Rejection criterion. Okay, so your rejection criterion ayat seperti biasa. Reject does not if chi squared cup more than berapa nilai awak? Your critical value. Okay. Step 6. Test statistic. Okay, dalam test statistik, apa yang perlu awak buat? You must copy the label O and E only. Okay, O and E only. O, E, this one adalah O minus E squared over E. Okay, so you just copy. This one you show one working. Okay, you show one working. Okay, and then here remember new table. This table after combining E. Dikatakan awak ada combine tadi. This one yang table dah combine siap-siap dah E awak. Okay, tak perlu copy yang lama tu. Kalau combine, you combine straight away. Okay. So your chi squared cup equals to sigma O minus E squared over E. So awak buatlah working awak and then you get your answer. Okay, and then last kali, number 7 is your conclusion. Okay, so kita ada since chi squared cup equals to berapa more than berapa we reject H0. And then awak buat ayat macam biasa. So kalau more than, bila more than dia berada dalam critical region. Okay, kalau less than dia berada outside. Since chi squared cup equals to berapa less than berapa, do not reject H0. And then ayat seperti biasa. So ini adalah steps in order for you to carry out your chi squared test. Okay, recall you. Okay, before we see example after this. Okay.
3.7 kita baca soalan, you understand the question and then baru you buat. Okay, you have 4 identical dice, 6 faces, 1 until 6. Maksudnya awak ada 4 biji dadu, 4 faces, face 0.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Macam biasa lah. Okay, and then kita balik sebanyak 200 kali, 200 times. So you ambil 4 dice, balik. Ambil 4 dice, balik. Ambil balik. Okay, let X be number of dice. Score are even. Maksudnya bila awak balik dadu, awak ada 1 until 6 kan. So you kira berapa nombor yang, berapa dadu yang even. Okay, berapa bilangan dadu yang even. Okay, so we have to explain why binomial might describe the distribution of X. So bila tanya pasal binomial, awak kena recall balik chapter 3 yang awak dah belajar tentang bermula trial. Okay, so A, yang pertama, we have fixed number of trial. Betul tak? Bila awak ada itu, awak ada 4 trial awak, which is 4. And awak fix 4 setiap kali awak balik, and awak ada 4. You don't change your N. Okay, yang kedua, awak ada fixed probability of success, which is P. Okay, P awak berapa? P awak adalah 1/2. Why 1/2? Because bila awak baling dadu awak, 3 akan dapat even. Daripada 1 dadu tu, 3 even. Faham tak? 3 out of 6. Okay, number 3, awak hanya ada 2 sahaja outcome, sama ada success or failure. 2 outcome only. Sama ada P ataupun Q. Dan yang keempat, each trial independent. Okay, so ini adalah 4 benda yang kita akan check in order for us untuk check sama ada dia adalah binomial or not. Okay, so kita start dengan the second part. Okay, second part kita nak guna this one, and then 5% significant level. So bila kita nak start, ingat dalam goodness of fit, if you can define your X, define your X first. Tapi bila baca dia aku salin je. X equals to number of dice whose score are even. Okay, so step 1, hypothesis, page 0 and page 1. Okay, so H0 kita apa? We are trying to test X is distributed as X follow binomial and P for 0.5. Okay, so kita punya this one, kita nak concluding this one lah. X is not distributed in this way. Okay, step 1, step 2, step 3, sorry, step 1, step 2 adalah if H0 is true, apa menjadi? X will follow binomial for 0.5 and the expected frequencies are. So apa yang perlu awak buat? Awak perlu buat table. Berapa table kita? 2. Okay, so kita salin table kita. So X 0 P E, E equals to NP. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then saya salin. Bila dia ada satu probability, this probability you must show the working. Okay, so tunjuk satu probability of x equals to 0. Macam mana x equals to 0? For choose 0, p power 0, p saya adalah 0.5, p power 0, and then q power 4. Okay, and then barulah awak tekan calculator. 4 choose. So this one saya dapat 1/16. Okay, and then kita check kalau 1, awak tak perlu tunjuk working dah sekali cukup. 1 is enough. This is 1/4. If 2, 3/8. 3, 1/4. 4, 1/16. Okay, this one awak boleh check dengan menggunakan calculator straight away. Tapi untuk yang pertama, you show your working, and then you must check probability awak ni cukup tak 1. It must be 1. Okay, 1/16, 1/4, 3/8, 1/4, 1/16, 1. Okay, kalau cukup 1, tak apa. Okay, so O kita ni sepatutnya 200. 41, 70, 60, 57, 22, 200. Okay, so now kita nak cari E kita. So tunjuk sekali working, 1/16 × 200. Okay, so 1/16. So this one saya dapat 12.5. Okay, yang kedua 4/50. Yang ketiga 3/8. 75. Yang keempat 50 and 12.5. Okay, awak kena tunjuk working yang pertama, awak kena tunjuk probability working yang pertama. Okay, so by looking here, before I proceed, sebelum saya pergi kepada degree of freedom, saya kena check ada tak small e. Okay, less than 5, bigger than 5, bigger. So saya tak ada. So maksudnya I'm safe. So saya boleh proceed kepada next step. Step 1, step 2, step 3, degree of freedom. V equals to k minus 1. K saya berapa? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minus 1, which is 4. Okay, step 3. Step 4, chi-square test at 5% significant level. So your alpha is 0.05, your chi-square alpha V 0.05, V awak adalah 4. Okay, so saya sketch dekat B. Okay, this is my sketching. Okay, so saya ambil table saya. So saya nak 4 and 95. 4, 95. 9, 4, 8. Okay, so rejection criteria: reject has not if chi square cut more than 9488. Okay, so step 1, hypothesis. Step 2, expected frequency. Step 3, degree of freedom. Step 4, significant level. Step 5, rejection criterion. Step 6, awak adalah test statistic. Awak kena salin balik label awak O and E. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So O E, O minus E square over E. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So 10, 41, 7, 5, 27, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12 jawab x minus y, like that x minus y square over y. Okay, and then tekan cap 10, 12.5.
Awak dapat cap di sini. Tapi working kita tutup 10 minus 12.5 square over 12.5. So awak dapat 0.5.
Next one, 41.50 1.62. Next one, 70.75 0.3333 57.50 0.98 22 and 12.5 7.22.
Okay, so chi squared cap equals to sigma O minus E squared over 3. 0.5 162 0.3333 98 722.
Okay, so 0.5 162 0.3333 98 722.
So saya dapat 10.6533. So ini adalah more than your 9.48. Okay, since chi squared cap equals to 10.6533 more than 9.488, we reject Fishman. There is sufficient evidence at 5% significant level to suggest that X is not distributed as X follow binomial and P. Okay, maksudnya dia follow another distribution, bukan dia binomial. Kalau kita guna 5% significant, then
thank you.
3.8 adalah soalan berkaitan dengan Poisson distribution. Okay, so the number of computer malfunction per day. So bila kita bercerita tentang Poisson, remember we need our space ataupun interval, time interval dia kita perlu. Okay, remember when we define Poisson, bila kita define Poisson, we need the interval. Okay, bila kita define binomial, mesti in favor of P. Macam tadi kita buat, kita cakap number of dice score even. Even tu adalah your P, probability of success awak. Mesti in favor of P. Kalau Poisson, mesti ada time interval, mesti ada space. Okay, so 260 days, ini adalah awak punya observed frequency. So kita nak 5% significant level for the Poisson distribution, mean is 1.25. Mean of Poisson, this one adalah lambda. Okay, remember. Okay, so bila saya nak start, seperti biasa, I have to define X saya. X adalah saling sahaja, number of computer malfunction per day in a company. Okay, step 1 saya define dulu. And then step 2, I need hypothesis H0 and H1. Okay, so kita nak follow Poisson kan. X is distributed as X follow Poisson lambda 1.25. Okay, dan H1 kita nak contradict our H0. X is not distributed in this way. Okay, so step 1 done. Okay, step 2 adalah if H0 is true, we need to calculate our E. If H0 is true, what happens if H0 is true? X will follow Poisson 1.25. And the expected frequencies are, so apa perlu kita buat? Kita perlu saling table. So this is your O, this is your P, this is E equals to NP. Okay? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so untuk Poisson, Poisson adalah discrete. So bila Poisson discrete, dia akan ambil a certain number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 until infinity. Faham ke? Discrete, but dia akan ambil sampai infinity. So bila kita buat X, kita sebenarnya kita masih lagi boleh cari probability for 6, 7, and 8, and 9, and 10, and so on. So this one kita buat dia more than or equals to 5. Maksudnya kita habiskan sampai 5 sahaja. The observed frequency memang sampai 5 sahaja. Tapi expected frequency sebenarnya saya boleh cari lagi 6, 7, 8. Tapi kita combinekan semua terus. So kita tulis sebagai more than or equals to 5. Okay, so O saya, O saya adalah 77, 90, 55, 35 and 3. Okay, for your probability, you must show once macam mana awak kira probability. So tulis kat bawah, probability of X equals to 0 equals to E minus lambda, lambda X over X factorial. So untuk mudahkan kerja awak, awak masukkan dalam kalkulator, masukkan formula. Tempat 0 ni awak jadikan dia sebagai X. So E to the power of negative 1.25, and then 1.25 to the power of tempat zero ni awak letak sebagai x divide by x factorial. Where is my factorial? So masukkan factorial. Okay, so tekan tab, kita start dengan 0. Okay, so saya dapat probability dia adalah 0.28650. So 0.28650. Okay, 1 pula calculate 1. Okay, 0.35813, 35813. 2, 0.22383, 22383. Okay, kalau 3, 0.09326. Kalau 4, 0.02914. Okay, untuk 5 and above, kalau awak tekan 5, awak dapat 5 saja. Kalau awak tekan 6, 6 saja. So what we do, we take 1, we minus everything. Kita take the complement. 1 minus 0.28650, 0.35813. 0.28850, 0.09326, 0.029314. So this one saya dapat 0.009314. Okay. So, sekarang saya cari P saya, saya nak ambil P darab dengan N. N saya adalah 260. So, 260 times X, 0.28650. So, this one saya dapat 74.49. Okay, next one, 0.35813. This one saya dapat 93.1138, 0.22383, 58.1958. Next one, 0.09326, 24.2476. Next one, 0.02914. 7.5764, 0.00914, 2.3764. Okay. So step 1, hypothesis done. Step 2, done. But apa yang saya cakap, bila kita dah siap E kita, you must check for small e. Apa maksud small e? Less than 5. Okay, 74, 93, 58, 24, 7. Okay, this is 2. Bila 2, ini kita kira sebagai small e. So, bila small e, awak ambil 2 ni, awak buat bracket, awak tulis combine. So, these 2 kita kena combine. Okay, so bila awak combine, the next step, bila saya cari degree of freedom, V equals to K minus 1. K saya adalah after I combine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bukan 6, ya, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because I combine already. So 5 minus 1 which is 4. Faham ke? So kita check for small e. Kalau kurang daripada 5, small e less than 5. So kita kena combine. Okay, and then chi-square test at 5% significant level, alpha saya adalah 0.05, chi-square alpha v, v saya adalah 4. Okay, chi-square alpha v 95 and 4. Once again 9.488. Okay, sketch 9.488. Okay, and then rejection criterion: reject H naught if chi square cut power more than 9.488. Okay, step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5. Step 6 adalah awak punya test statistic. So what you need to do? You must update O, E. But this one aku belum combine lah. So so kita tulis. So this is our O, this is our E, this is our O minus E square over E. So 77, 90, 55, 30. But remember, these two we have to combine, kan? So 5 and 3 saya combine jadi 8. Okay, E saya 74.49, 93.1138, 58.1958, 24.2476. These two I have to combine. Okay, untuk saya letak kat sini. Okay, so 7.5764, 2.3764, so 9.9528. Okay, so remember the first working saya kena tunjuk. Kalau awak rasa kecil kat sini untuk tunjuk, awak buat dekat bawah dia. Okay, so 77.74.49 square over 74.49. Okay, so masuk kalkulator sahaja. X minus Y, X minus Y square over Y. Okay, 77.74.49. So here saya dapat 0.0 8 4 5 7 8 8 5 8. Okay, 93.1138, 0.104 13 10 4 13. Okay, next one 55 58.1958, 0.17 450. Next one 30 24.2476, 1.36468. Next one 8 and 9.9528, 0.38315. Okay, and then chi square cut equal to sigma O minus E square divided by E. Okay, so campurkan semua, 0.0848 10413 10413 13 4 6 8 3 8 3 1 5. Okay, 0.08458 10413 So saya dapat 2.11104. Okay. So bila saya dah siap, saya pun tulis conclusion. Since dan square cut 2.11104, which is way less than 9.488, do not reject measurement. Okay. So kita tulis conclusion, there is insufficient evidence at 5% significant level to suggest that 1 question 7.
Okay, so you are given district. Nampak tak district? Kenapa saya cakap district?
Because 1, 2, 3, 4. Maksudnya kita ambil a certain number only.
Okay, and then function dia bagi kepada kita x over 10 and 0 pada y. Maksudnya kita hanya ada 4 only.
This is the observation of 70. 70 observation, and then kita dapat observe frequency. Dan kita nak buat chi square test, 1% significant level.
Okay, so kita start. Biasanya kalau boleh define, awak define. This one I cannot define, there is nothing to define. So kita tak perlu define. So my H0 and H1, x is distributed as this one. Px equals to x, x over 10, 0. Otherwise, x equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. This one, x is not distributed in this way.
If H naught is true, what happens? Px equals to x equals to x over 10 and the expected frequency. Okay, so after your what you must do your okay, your X, your O, your P, your E. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4 for 2018-28. Okay, probability saya. This one actually very easy, we just need to sum on this. So 1 over 10, 2 over 10, 3 over 10, 4 over 10. Okay? And then entry your what? We just need to multiply by 17. So 7, 14, 21, 28. Okay, and then I'm going to check for small e. Everything is bigger than 5. Okay, but remember, I want to show working satu kan. Okay, this one very easy, no need lah. Okay, this one I want to show np, 70 times 1 over 10. Okay, show one working. This one, perlu ke? Okay, kalau ada tulis, kalau boleh tulis. Px equals to 1 equals to 1 over 10. Just sum. Okay? Step 1, step 2, step 3. Okay, step 3 saya adalah degree of freedom. K minus 1. K saya adalah 4 minus 1, which is 3. Chi squared test at 1% significant level. So saya punya alpha is 0.01 chi squared alpha V. Okay, refer to your level. V saya adalah bigger, 1% maksudnya 99, 11.34. And then sketching 11.34. Step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5. Reject H0 if the squared card more than 11.34. And then, saya kena buat test statistic. I copy this one. Okay.
square over E. Okay, for 2018-28, 7-14-21-28, 4 minus 7 square over 7.
Okay, working tunjuk satu. Dalam calculator, masukkan X minus Y. Over Y, and then tekan kap 4, 7. This one adalah 1.28571. 28571. Next one, 2014, 2.57143. Next one, 1821, 0.42857.
Next one, 2828 is 0. Okay, and then chi squared cut equals to sigma O minus E squared over E. 1.28571, 2.57143, 42857 plus 0. Okay? 1.28571, 2.57143, 0.42857, 4.28571. Conclusion. Since chi squared cut 4.28571 less than 11.34, do not reject H0. There is insufficient evidence at 1% significant level to suggest that X is not distributed as Px equals to X, X over 10, X equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So, ini adalah chi squared test.